Welcome to Western Pennsylvania, Oakmont, the home of this match play challenge at Oakmont, part of the USGA eSports Grand Slam, our third event of this season, presented by Lexus. I'm Jeff Eisenband. I'll be with you as we get to this final four of this event. Jules, Brook is here as well. Oakmont should provide quite a test for these four players today.
Absolutely. Jeff, I'm going to level with you. I am struggling to contain my excitement. It's just such an awesome event. It's my first match play event that I'm going to be commentating on. But also, what a month for golf this month in September. It's the BMW PGA here, our flagship event of the European Tour. And then, of course, you've got the Solheim and Ryder Cups back to back. And what better way to celebrate this than our own match play challenge event at Oakmont from the USGA. It's just too much.
Fresh off the Walker Cup as well, the U.S. Amateur, U.S. Mid-Amateur just taking place. Congrats to Stuart Hagestad on his third title. Four players in this match play challenge at Oakmont. They've all qualified to get here. There was a big bracket. You could break things down into four different quads, different quarters of the bracket. And that is where we stand today as we get to 18-hole match play at Oakmont. First place, you'll get a $750 prepaid gift card, a $500 USGA shop card. So we're playing for something. Some of those match play events you mentioned, Jules, it's all pride. There's something here. There's a monetary reward. All four of these players who've gotten here are at least going home with something. This is the bracket. You see Young 46 and F Magnets jump out. You might expect that to be the final, but Blaze Alex, Ishimi 31, they're trying to mess that all up.
Oh, yes. And they've got, you know, they've got stuff to play for. And they've really upped the ante, the USGA, from last year as well. So those prizes have got bigger. And I believe Young 46 and Blaze Alex, are just about to tee off.
They are. As we take a look at Oakmont Country Club, one of the most historic courses in the world, historic in the United States. And it has hosted the U.S. Open more times than any other golf course.
That's right, 9 times. And, of course, in 2025, the U.S. Open will revisit Oakmont, and that will be for its 10th time. Pretty unbelievable. Yeah, the course is steeped in history. I think it's been going since 1903. That's a really, really long time. And, of course, it's home of the iconic Church Pew Bunker, which I believe are between holes 3 and 4. You can see them from satellite vision. They're pretty obvious and they're pretty iconic of Oakmont. And there are lots of other bunkers there too. Over 100 of them. And, of course, they're famously fast greens here, Jeff. They're yes. Gonna wreak havoc with the play, most definitely. It's all about the green speed.
Yeah, Western Pennsylvania's own Arnold Palmer once said you can hit 72 greens out here at Oakmont and you can still not come close to winning, was what he said. So that's a little bit of the gist of the test that we're going to get, as well as those 9 U.S. Opens. You mentioned 6 U.S. Amateurs, 2 U.S. Women's Opens as well, coming through the Pittsburgh area. And we will add this event today to all of those theatrics. Young 46, let's talk about him. We're about to take a look at his match. We saw at that virtual U.S. Open a few weeks back, didn't quite have his best stuff. Jay Smithers getting the best of him here. And this is an opportunity for redemption in a match play format. There's Blaze Alex getting things started, who is going to be Young 46's opponent today.
Yes, Young 46, Jason, he is an absolute Trojan of this game. There are few people with more experience than him. I mean, the only other person I can think of, a really small handful of people, and F Mags, who's playing today, and some others that didn't qualify. So, yeah, the eyes will be on him. But Blaze Alex, he's got something to prove. You know, he managed to pip Jay Smithers to the post. He beat him in the quarterfinals to get here. And funnily enough, last year, Jay Smithers beat Blaze Alex in the quarterfinals to make it into the semis and to win. So it's a very interesting turn of events. So it's the kind of the opposite of what happened last year. Anyway, let's see how he does today. Here he is on the first green, and he's made it here.
Young 46. Yeah, Jules, he's got the backwards hat going, mirroring his own look. Right now, 79,536 $1 million made in this game. One of the best to ever do it, and trying to add to that resume today.
I'm loving these cameras, Jeff. I don't know about you, but I just love to see the emotion on their faces, their responses, reactions. Not always that we have the pleasure of this, but this is a real bonus for watching.
And that's an outstanding start for Young 46. Pressure already on Blaze Alex. Young 46. I mean, these cameras, Jules, we gotta tell the Ryder Cup television folks to get these sort of cameras going in real life in 2 weeks.
Absolutely. Or in the Solheim Cup, and that's just next week. Gosh, it's all happening. And of course, we've got the shot clock here just to add a little bit more pressure onto those. Perhaps it will affect more the less experienced players, if that's fair to say. Shouldn't affect someone like Young 46.
Young 46 has been doing this in his sleep, and there's an early concession of a putt from Blaze Alex. They'll have the first hole with birdies as we go to two. Some helping wind here.
So the first sort of opportunity to score really low is on the fourth, if you've got a good wind, if you don't have a headwind. So I'll be interested to see what they score on that hole, which is coming up shortly. But yeah, greens are going to be super fast here.
Jules, one of the interesting parts about match play in this game, WGT, as opposed to the stroke play that we've seen in the past, when we've seen these stroke play competitions, different wins for different players. Match play, yeah. Both players, they're getting the same wind, and they're also able, if you're hitting second off the tee or second on approach, you do get the opportunity to see how the wind will affect the shot from your opponent.
That is really interesting. And actually, I think that's fair, and it should be like that. I mean, a lot of players have sort of said that, you know, they've missed a title purely because of the wind algorithm. So this is great. The same conditions for both contenders.
Sound play so far from Alex. Young 46, just a lob wedge in hand.
Funny enough, we have championship conditions here, but the winds, you know, the wind so far has been pretty slow winds, nothing too high. I'm not used to seeing something as low as that, just to 9 miles an hour. Do you know what I mean? On one of these events.
We get a heartbeat for Young 46 and just spins behind the hole. You can see he didn't feel like he got everything on that shot. Was off a little bit on his clicks, but he's going to make Alex putt this out.
Yeah, I would.
There's some gamesmanship that will happen today.
You're the experienced one, Jeff. What have you seen?
Well, it's a matter of, you know, in terms of the putt concessions. You know, if you're on Alex's end, you've now conceded two putts to Young 46. Yes, Young 46 was inside you both times, but you're going to be expecting that in return as we go on. So there's a little bit of just good karma and good sportsmanship that you're expecting. But I would say this, Jules, as the day progresses and we separate from all square, that's where maybe there's going to be a little bit of a different gamesmanship played.
Yeah, but you're sort of setting, you're saying that the tone is going to be set early on for good gamesmanship, with the hope that this will then benefit them in some way coming up the home stretch in the last few holes.
I think that's the goal, but as soon as someone misses a 5 or 6 footer, they're not going to get those 3 or 4 footers given to them as they are early on.
And here we are on the third with the first appearance of the church pew bunker on the left of the fairway there. It's quite a brutal looking bunker, isn't it? Also called the coffin bunker.
It's a little bit of a sharper way to put it.
Yeah, exactly. Little omen. What's where your golf game dies, perhaps? I don't know.
You could see how much this hole slopes off on the left side. Mm. And you're right, Jules. These players not needing to deal with terrible winds early. Another good shot by Young 46, but for the first time today, he will putt first on the green. A little bit down the hill, 8 feet for Young 46. We appreciate everyone starting to tune on in over on Twitch and YouTube. Buckle up. Final four of our match play at Oakmont competition. Young 46 and Blaze Alex to get us going. That's just a good stroke from Young 46, taking care of business right down the center. Jules mentioned off the top, Oakmont, part of the inspiration for the stimp meter. We're reading these at 13 championship speed at Oakmont right now. Alex working quickly.
Again, I think the algorithm's being a bit kinder because I've known these to get up to 14. And they can be brutal. And you know what? In fact, Jeff, we were talking earlier on about how, about Jack Nicklaus's what he thought about these greens. And you know, for the 2007 U.S. Open, they had to slow down these greens. That's how fast they were. And that's a U.S. Open that likes to sort of, you know, annihilate players, right?
I think if I was in charge, we'd be looking at a much different... I would set this course up as hard as possible in real life and in this game. As you see right
totally.
Now, check out, Jules, the angle that these players are taking down that right side. That is to an opposite fairway. So players trying on the 609-yard hole, both players trying to cut this as close as they possibly can and potentially trying to use that wind to give themselves an opportunity here at getting into this par 5 and 2.
Yeah.
You talked about it off the top, this fourth
Absolutely.
Hole, a critical
yep.
moment in match play.
It is. It's one of those holes that everyone is going to want to take advantage of. This one and 17, I believe, are the two hot holes that everyone will have in mind that they could, you know, they could do something. But of course, as you said, the winds are the same, so they both got the same chance. But I guess with match play, a lot of players tend to take, is it fair to say, a little more risk?
Yeah, I think that's fair. You're
willing,
not,
willing
you're
to
not
take
dealing,
on that, yeah.
Yeah, you're not dealing with any potential blow-up holes. Every hole's worth the same.
Yeah. Where is it? Oh.
That is Alex running a 3-iron up beautifully.
Stunning. Doesn't look happy, or maybe is he just relieved that it's over? Is that what that sort of face and shaking the head was and big exhaling?
You know, he thinks he should have been closer, and obviously you're dealing with Young 46, who's going to be a little bit closer. That is a difficult shot to judge the run-up, even in this game, even with the best players.
I think he did spectacularly. Mm.
See if Young 46 goes to that 3-iron as well. He's got 3-wood in hand, so see, taking a little bit more club and laying back with it.
Oh,
and getting
he's
a heartbeat.
Got the heartbeat. Absolutely. It was worth him taking his time. Look at that. And Blaze Alex will be putting first.
So that right there is a little bit of Alex's frustration, was even putting this to 12 feet in two. He had a hunch that Young 46 was going to be able to make something happen. Alex choosing to hit the 3-iron full and get it to this point. Critical putt in the match. Not a whole lot in this. Young 46 should have some slope to deal with, even with a shorter putt.
Just coming to the end of his time, if you notice. Used that full minute to set up, and it was worth it. How about that?
I think we've seen about 7 deep exhales from Alex already so far today. So he's been feeling he's been feeling a little of the pressure.
He's only on the fourth hole as well.
Now Young 46, shorter putt, but much more downhill.
Yeah.
Well and done. Jules, that's what you talk about. A little bit more conviction used by Young 46 there. A little bit more speed downhill than we might see in a stroke play event where you can blow two shots up right there.
Yeah.
And now to 5. 4 halved holes to start. Short par 4 here.
Quite a big tailwind going on as well. The wind seems to be picking up today at Oakmont, Jeff.
It's getting a little, you know, it's September weather in the Pittsburgh area.
Oh, sit. That's right at the edge of the fairway there. In real life, players tend to use a long iron off the tee here.
These guys are simply more precise. Some mention in the chat about, of course, Young 46, known for his tactics, using a calculator. He's got a whole menu sheet when you see him play in person. So he's judging that tee shot to get to the end of the fairway and stay on, even with a full shot.
Yeah, I mean, it's another level.
Heartbeat for Alex. Special.
Oh, wow. What's that, 2.5 feet?
Well, it was another exhale, but I don't think he'll need to stress over the putt.
No. That tailwind really helping him take advantage of that hole.
Yeah, not a heartbeat for Young 46. A bit of a miscue there. This is going to be speedy down the hill. 2 inches down the hill, just inside 12 feet.
Yeah, I wouldn't like this putt, Jeff.
No.
Not at all. Especially knowing where my opponent is. First time that Young 46 seems to have been put under some kind of pressure. Now, either he's completely still, or I think his camera may have had a slight issue because he's completely frozen. But I'd love to know how he'll be expressing himself.
Yeah, I think we can just believe that this is how Young 46 looks when he's locked in on a putt.
Yeah, just completely transfixed.
Wow, what a bender.
Yeah. He knew it wasn't an easy putt. Yeah, a little bit of frustration there.
Slides off the table, and there's that gamesmanship we talk about. Young 46 is going to concede the putt and concede the hole to Alex.
Oh, he had to. He had to. He had to, Jeff. Yeah.
So look at some of Alex's putting already. These were the eagle putts from both of these two guys on 4. But it's Alex with the first win of a hole today on 5, and now we go to the par 3 6. You can see all that slope around this green. Doesn't like it.
Yeah, you don't want to miss right, but at least he's in the center of the green. No, shaking his head. It's not where he planned for it to go.
So now Young 46, still locked in, Jules. But needs a big moment here. Coming off that par and a loss of hole of 5. It's okay.
So he's ever so slightly nearer, but it's still... Oh, no. He's a little bit further away. Okay, I couldn't see from the angle.
He's slightly away, but maybe learning from that last shot, you could see this basically a flat putt. It's got a big break to it, but he won't have to deal with as much downhill as he just dealt with and perhaps Alex is about to deal with.
Yeah, you really got to pick your positions on the green and stick to them at Oakmont.
That was not precise with the accuracy for Young 46.
Yeah, and he's done the opposite of his last putt, actually. The last big putt he had on the 5th. So this one was a little high.
With Alex well downhill, just inside 6 inches downhill, but not too much break in this. That's an effort he'd like back. And they'll each concede these two. So they tie with pars.
Yep. So Blaze Alex still one up as they are a third of their way through their 18 holes if they get to 18.
Long par 4, 7th, helping wind for both these players, though.
It's a tricky par 4 with a green that severely slopes from left to right here. And you do not want to miss left.
No, and... These pins, these match play pins, are more forgiving today. But a big difference here, who can find that slope? You talk about that left to right movement on the green, Jules. Who can run this correctly?
Oh, heartbeats for Blaze Alex.
Wants it a little deeper. That'll be below the hole, though.
He still doesn't seem fully satisfied at that. Shook his head ever so slightly.
Another heartbeat that got back there. But here we go again, Jules. That's going to be a sloping putt.
Yeah. Young 46 being such a success story in WGT and accomplishing so much. I wonder how it feels to sort of not be the front runner and come kind of being, you know, a little bit of the underdog in these last few holes. I wonder how that sort of affects Young 46. It's probably a place he's not used to being.
That putt was hit with some conviction.
Yeah. Well done.
He might feel like Rory losing to Ludwig by 9 in 2 days and 36 holes, Jules.
Very good. Oh, it was great watching them at the PGA on Thursday, Jeff. It really was. There's lots of Team Europe Ryder Cup groupings, obviously organized by Captain Luke Donald. And a lot of laughs, a lot of team bonding, it looked like, going on. And, yeah, I'm very excited for the Ryder Cup and, of course, Solheim Cup next weekend as well. Ooh, that did look like it was going in.
And now you go from feeling like you had a chance to go two up just a few moments ago to being tied once again through seven. Door is open for Young 46. 299 yards this par three into the wind, down the hill. You're going to see it's going to be tough for these players to even get it back there. But Young 46 is going to try to pop a driver. See if he goes topspin.
Oh, and he's got the heartbeats. Oh, and he is very near that hole. Yeah, he'll be happy with that.
Is outstanding. And pressure shifting right back to Alex.
Not
he gets
a set
his own
of heartbeats. Not as close to the pin, but successful shot.
And now again up the hill for Alex. Not a ton of break in this. All good there. This down the hill. Let's see. Yes, there it is. There's the concession. Even down the hill. Alex isn't going to make him putt that. Hey, guess what? We're going to bring in a guest right now. I hope that even though he's not playing, I hope the trains are still running in the Chicagoland area right now. Jay Smithers is joining us as we get a look at this matchup. We appreciate you being here on a day that you did not qualify for this event due to Alex that we're watching.
Yes, Alex got me. We tied actually in the finals, and but he had a better back nine.
It was very close, wasn't it?
It was. We were deadlocked. He shot 9 under on the back, though I shot 7. I had a 8 front, 7 back. He went 6 front, 9 back, so he really turned it on there in the back nine and took the tiebreaker.
And Josh, as we watch this, we're getting the full emotions of having this camera on Alex right now. Obviously, you've played many matches in your life against Young 46. I mean, we're watching all the emotions from Alex right now, and it definitely felt like on that front nine, he had his opportunities to get out in front.
Oh, absolutely. Honestly, both of them have made some mistakes that are kind of not like them. This one right here, this is a giant mistake by Alex. That putt is an absolute nightmare. But Oakmont can do that to you. It's a very touchy course.
Young 46, this hole sloping off to the right, but wind moving right to left.
Josh, because Alex beat you in the quarterfinals, do you find yourself, and it is a match play event after all, do you find yourself rooting for Jason a little more, or Alex either side?
I mean, I love both these guys. I've known them both for years now. Jason, obviously, a little longer, and me and Jason are pretty close. But I told Alex before the match, I said, if you're going to beat me, then you got to go win it all.
You know? Yeah, exactly.
You got to represent bracket number two, which we were in together. So, I mean, it's his job now to go win this whole thing.
Yeah.
And this is a critical putt for him.
I love these two guys. Yeah, this putt is just an absolute nightmare because it loses so much speed coming up that hill that you have to actually hit it a little harder than you think. But the problem with that is it can run down 8-9 feet and leave you a really tough par putt. It's just a nightmare over here. Gonna cut in front, and then that's a pretty good play, but it's very conservative, just knowing that that ball's never going in with that pace.
But maybe Alex not feeling confident in Jason on this putt.
100% that played a factor. If Jason stuffed this, you know, at a 4 or 5 feet or something, I think Alex is a lot more aggressive on his putt. Match play is beautiful like that. You can, you know, if your opponent's close, you can really just try to take some of that breakout and jam it.
We got some questions already coming at you in the chat. Primer Lance wants to know your beard regimen, Josh.
All right. So I got to plug the beard regimen again. Okay, I've done this a few times for these guys. It's free advertisement, but eventually they're going to have to pay me. So I use, and we're getting serious here, I use a company called Rinse and Robust. And we go shampoo, conditioner, shampoo 3 times a week, conditioner twice, and then you throw the beard oil on after you're out of there, and it just makes a majestic beard.
It's definitely a good recipe. I mean, it looks fantastic, Josh, really. Better than ever.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, she's nice and full right now. She's really, really growing in well this time.
Lance, I hope you had the comms up for that. As we take a look at the back nine here at the 10th at Oakmont. So we go to the other side of the street in real life.
And they're both kicking themselves right now. I feel like they both probably think they should be 2 up.
Just 138 in right now for Alex. And you look at these pins. We've been called the match play pins throughout the day. You could salivate over some of these if this was stroke play.
Oh, yeah. This pin in particular with this wind is, I mean, you're thinking, you know, potential eagle with this wind, being that it's sloping right to left and the wind's going right to left. So you can land it to the right of the hole pretty much anywhere. And let it just funnel down.
And look at that. Very good position.
A touch left.
It's okay. He's giving himself an uphill putt.
Yeah, Alex will make that bird.
Yeah. Puts all that much more pressure on Jason knowing where he is with this approach. But he's also got the
Jason
heartbeats.
Definitely played it to the right, so he's playing that slope, but he just got a little too far. Definitely. Let's go back to his freeze cam, though. I was really liking that. He looks so stoic, like, yeah.
I mean, his camera is working, but actually, he doesn't naturally move that much, does he?
No, he doesn't.
Can just he about doesn't.
When
see
we were in
breathing.
Dubai, I was, yeah, he was, we were in Dubai and I was poking him while he's playing and he just never moved. I'd like throw things at him or kick his sheets on the floor and he just never moved.
Well, that's right. When you play golf, it's about taking out the variables, right? So if you keep the body absolutely still and just moving what you need to live.
Yep. Yeah, he's a fantastic match play player because he I don't think he feels, you know, any of the extra pressure. I was going to say anything, but I felt like that was too much. That's a great putt.
Well done. Yeah.
Alex has a pretty straight uphill four-footer. This, I would think Jason's going to concede it.
He thought about it for a second.
Maybe not. You know, there's like a little tactic we use sometimes. Like, if you're like kind of on that borderline of a concede or not concede, like I'll wait like 30 seconds and then concede it right before you hit it. Just, it's, you know, just a little, you know.
Yeah. Just get them slightly riled. So actually, that's
Make them do all the work and then be like, "I don't worry about it." Right, right. Yeah. I've seen all that work you put in, but don't worry about it. It's in.
That's proper expert tactics, Josh. I like
it. Yeah. Oh, absolutely. It's match play is a total different beast. This pin could yield a hole one by one of these two. This pin's kind of a little tricky pin back there.
What do you think about this wind on this hole, Josh?
It's actually a really good wind for this back pin because the green slopes left to right back there. So, again, they're going to be able to play a ball off to the left of the hole and let it kind of just funnel towards it. Alex hit a lot of power there, though. I don't know. Maybe his driver doesn't go as far, but he could potentially be in the rough. Yep. Too much power.
First miss fairway.
That's just going to depend
today
on the lie. Yeah, he could. I mean, he could have anything from, you know, the first cut 25-30 all the way to 40-50 on that lie, and 40-50 would not be good.
A little extra look here from Young 46.
Yeah. He really likes these underpowered 9-irons. He hates the pitching wedge with a passion. Yeah, that's perfect.
Keeps it below the hole enough. And we don't see these shots a lot. How do you deal with coming out of the rough in this game?
He got a great lie. This really shouldn't be an issue. 25-30s, it only adds like a yard or two with the sand wedge in your hand. He's probably pretty happy about this. Yeah, again, that's fine there.
What is the range of concession here? These are 7 feet, each about 6 or 7 feet.
Both of these are getting putted. No, nobody's conceding these two putts. Usually, I mean, the general rule of thumb is about 3 feet. And then, you know, if you know the putt's straight from 4 feet, you give it to your opponent. But 6 or 7 feet, you're going to putt it.
And Alex gave a little tilt to the head there.
Yeah, he almost missed that. You know, it's really fun. Make your opponent putt like a one-footer and then give them a six-footer on the next hole. Just really totally mess with their minds.
Yeah, it's a lot of the game is very much mental, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. It's just a lot of fun.
To get inside your head, yeah. Or to throw you in match play.
Oh, yeah.
For Jason, everyone in the right chat, here, we want to hear your concession ideas.
Yes, please get in touch with us on Twitch. That will be excellent viewing.
I have a controversial stance on the concedes. I personally think you should have to putt everything, but that's just me. Some people are they get a little upset when you don't concede putts to them.
Some people are also impatient.
They are. Especially this game brings out some strange characters, man. People get really mad. They're like, you've taken 20 seconds to hit this tee shot. I'm like, I have six kids and I'm making coffee. And let's pump the brakes a little bit, guy. Like, where are you going?
I suppose in these sort of big match play events, Ryder Cup, Solheim Cup, you've got, you know, you're playing for honor, right? So it's about that sort of sportsmanship and, you know.
Oh, absolutely.
In quotation marks, and it's not a very woke word, but, you know, gentlemanly kind of attitude. So it's kind of like, yeah, it's interesting to bring that into it. But I totally see what you're saying, that putting out is what everyone should do. And then it's one blanket kind of.
It's not popular making people putt.
Oh, yeah.
But I've also seen people miss two footers in this game. It's like, you know.
Yeah. And also, a lot of people in real life, a lot of people can't see the greens and see what their lines are like. And so it's easier to understand why they made them putt out if you're there, but how many people are actually.
If you got to give the cup away from 3 feet, it's like, you know, you should probably have to putt that.
We shall see.
We have a Ryder Cup going on. We did East versus West this year, Ryder Cup. And WGT, it's community organized. But we're going to try to do a little streaming.
You're from
here.
Illinois, so what does that qualify you for?
Well, East vs. West World. Okay. So I will be – I'm the captain of the West team.
Ah, right. Who's playing?
So we got a pretty good lineup. We got Master Hacker. You guys obviously know him. Jason, Young 46. We got DB Stronghold. You guys have met him. Magic Ire, Evan ECC, Thunderbird. I mean, it's a pretty chock full lineup of fun.
Oh, look at that shot! Sorry, just that
what a dandy
approach on the 12th by Jason.
Alex is making a run at a late captain's pick for you guys if you don't have him already.
the picks are already in. There was a tournament. We got a couple guys from the tournament, but. Alex did not. I mean, he should, the way he's playing right now, but he is not on the team this year.
A lot of Adrian Maronk energy right now from him, Jules.
Yeah. Gosh, yeah. And he's
trying
to.
Oh, no.
That's gosh, just so Alex. Brutal. He hammered it. He went with the jam.
And that might be the difference.
No, Jason's putting that. I don't care. I don't care who it is. They're putting that. I don't care if it's WGT champion and all his hacks that he uses.
Jason was saying something. I'm not sure if any of you guys picked up on that.
Well, he seemed very relieved.
He can't believe he won that hole.
Yeah.
So we've got big Tarwins here on the 13th par 3.
And he's got the I like to miss late there. I like to lay. Everything slopes right to left. That's going to be really good.
Don't stay there. Come down.
Now we can hear his mic.
little luck.
Not bad, though.
That putt is so fast. He is not. Odds are you don't make par when you're there. A lot of times it's either birdie or bogey. Ooh, that pole's going to hurt. From that side, it rips down pretty far. Yeah, there it goes. Ooh, Alex.
That's a big putt.
Another look at that putt from Alex that just...
You guys are reliving it? Oh!
That was somewhere... That might have been a... a 270 there.
I hope this isn't Alex's actual screen. That's just mean.
Oh, man, this game has definitely turned here. Alex has a really weird putt right here, too. This is one of those putts you kind of got to know. The majority of people miss it pretty high. So we'll see what Alex does here.
And, of course, being one down, there's just that, you know, tiny bit of added pressure as well on something like this.
Yeah, that's going to be high.
You know, oh.
It's just, there's something weird about that putt. It just doesn't move until the end. So now Jason's got a, he's got a decision to make. He could hammer this in and play very little break, or he's going to tap it down the hill. Oh, he's going with the smash.
What do you do, Josh?
Smash.
Well done.
I'd have made the cup longer.
Josh, would he even consider that in a stroke play event, that line?
Depending on where he's at in it. So if you need the birdie, if you have to have it, then yes, that's what you do. But if you have a really good round going and it doesn't kill you to make a par there, then no, you probably play more break and less speed. DB Stronghold says that's always how you putt that, and that is why we never see DB Stronghold in these events.
Is that
well, let's see what he comes back with.
Is that the captain trying to motivate his player a little bit?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get him going a little bit.
I was going to say, that's slightly Tiger Woods' dad techniques, isn't it?
I love DB. He's a great dude. He's hilarious. And I just like to give him a little crap once in a while.
Locker room chat. All good.
73 yeah, yards definitely. For Young 46.
He's licking his chops here. Great number. Great wind. This shot has a tendency to go a little long, though, so we'll see if he comes off it a little. Yeah, no beats. Odds are it's going to... Oh, he just spun it a little. That's a good shot.
Oh, and high.
DB's super defensive in the chat right now, which is what I was going for.
Well, now he's got something to prove, right? So that's
He says, I won the last one. Nobody even remembers the last one, brother. Come on now. Uh-oh, that might go.
Oh.
Ooh.
Oh, wow. Oh, that just kissed it.
Josh, a little bit in the chat, WGT Golfer 2022 asking about no punch shot there. Both players going with full shots.
Yeah, so a little bit of course knowledge there, knowing that. So if you look about 10 feet in front of that pin, there's a hump. So if you don't carry the hump, you'll stay on the back side of it. But if you do carry it, it'll kick. So the full shot's just a more controllable shot into that pin.
I was going to say.
Alex will not be conceding putts the rest of this round, by the way. Not two down. You're making everything if I'm two down.
So, Young 46, two up as they tee off on the 15th hole. It's around 500 yards. Long par four here.
It's going to be a great angle for Young 46 on that right side of the fairway.
Yeah, this hole should probably burn. So, there's that. It's one of the few holes that if WGT ever gave me power to like eliminate things, this hole would be one of the first to go.
Those famous this one cost me my left side.
Yeah, this one cost me my tournament here.
Oh, is this what happened?
I parred this hole. Yep. Birdie would have won it for me. I parred it because I hate it and it hates me and we're just not friends.
Yeah. There's Alex with the heartbeats here on 15.
Yeah, that's a good looking ball too. He's gonna land it long and spin it down the hill. Ooh, the blood roll. Jason is in the driver's seat.
All right. He has got a nasty, nasty putt coming.
As you heard by Jason's commentary there, he agrees. It is not a good putt.
So how will that affect his approach in terms of where he's trying to place this golf ball?
I think he's going to be ultra aggressive with this. I think he's going to try to pretty much make it dormy here going into 16. He's not really the guy who's like, oh, I'm going to play this safe. He's more, you know, sees blood in the water and attacks type guy.
No, turn over.
Oh, that pull is not good.
But he's still nevertheless got the heartbeats.
Spin.
Yep. You may see a wedge on the green from there.
Gotta ding that.
So whose putt would you prefer here, Josh?
I told you this hole is the worst. I would prefer never putting on it. But if I had to choose, I'd choose Jason's just because it's shorter.
Yeah.
But they're both not good, and this hole is just bad. It's a bad hole. Good looking putt. Oh wow, that's a dandy.
Well done. Putting a little bit of pressure on Jason there as he lines up. Oh, feeling very confident.
Sounds like he's gonna putt it. I thought we might see the wedge.
So what would you do with the wedge? Sorry, I'm a very unseasoned player. Sporadic player on WGT. How would you'd do a putting stroke with a wedge, or?
No, you take out a full shot wedge, and you can just eliminate, see how that foot break is kind of just, you could skip over the foot break. You basically leave it in the center of the hole, and foot break with it.
Oh, wow. Okay, that is just way too high risk for me to even think about.
Young 46 can put the match away by winning this hole. Par 3, 16th. Down the hill, downwind.
This is a toughie. Good win, though. Coming off the left.
Pretty large green here.
It is, and you can land this ball left of the hole, especially with the shot they're going to play. They're going to play probably a spinny 3-iron in there, and it should funnel down towards the right. Good dang.
Get a tap in, please. Downs. Ooh, yeah.
It's
easy,
money.
Easy.
Oh, it ripped.
Jeez.
A little door open there for Alex. He's going to probably play a very similar shot. Oh, he's going for the gold. He went through it long left and spin it down.
Oh, it's rolling towards the hole.
And Josh, this
downhill putt, though.
This is the risk, right? You throw it back there, it doesn't come all the way down.
Mm-hmm.
And now he'll have
Jason's
a downhill putt.
Much better. Yeah, 100%, Jeff. That. He took the big risk there, but it didn't do exactly what he wanted. Went a little long, and now Jason's definitely back in the driver's seat with this putt. Oh, the chat is so funny.
Oh, big.
That's a big putt.
This to extend the match for Alex.
Did you guys get to meet Ishimi yet? Ishimi Gavin?
Not yet, actually.
Oh, Gavin's cool. He's a good dude.
That match just moments away from beginning. Ishimi against F. Magnet, second match of the day. But right now, Young 46, two up. He is in with birdie at 16. Alex trying to match him with birdie to keep this thing alive. And he gets the rim in this time.
But, I mean, wow. In a split second, so many emotions.
What a nice putt.
Now, this one of those trademark holes, yeah.
I think he smiled for the first time in this round just now.
Jason's got a little longer driver as Alex is not as high of a level, so he can't get the longer driver. This is definitely advantage Young 46 here.
So the other eagle opportunity here on Oakmont.
Great ball.
And he's, yeah.
And with that, you're basically demanding, you're challenging Alex to make eagle because Young 46 just needing a halve to end the match.
Yeah, he's, I mean, at worst, he'll two putt from there and get his birdie. So Alex definitely is looking for the big bird here.
Yeah, certainly from the two holes left to play, this is the one.
Well, that went left. He's in trouble. See the difference in driver there?
And now he's going to need something special.
So you were talking about Ishimi, and although we don't know him, I was looking at his stats. Do you know, interestingly, his scoring average is lower than Young 46. Not by much. 49.14. Mm-hmm. Jason.
Yeah, Ishimi is... He is a... he's a really good player. He played in some E-Tour events.
Okay.
I will say, I mean, so our WGT scoring average is kind of skewed because it only keeps X amount of rounds. So,
oh, I see. Okay.
So if I have, say, like my 500th round is a 59, and then your next round you shoot is 53, it kicks the 59 out and puts the 53 in. So that's why you're going to see the averages kind of get to that, you know, 49.
I mean, obviously,
you know, Jason's average, yeah, but it doesn't make something here. One out of, you know, 75 rounds, you know, you shoot 49.
I see. I mean, obviously, I know that Young 46 has played a lot more. So, yeah.
Yeah.
I'd assume that was the case that when you're taking more rounds. You're gonna obviously it's gonna affect your scoring average, but
they kick out the worst round out of the, you know, the pool of rounds, and then they also keep, like, there's something called a clash in this game, and it's used with like apparel.
Sorry, Alex.
You get shorter tees, and then you get like these long clubs, you know, 320 yard drivers and stuff that definitely play a factor into scoring averages.
Heard Young 46 apologize to Alex there. You get two timeouts. Running out of time was Young 46. He needs a two-putt to wrap this thing up.
I'll yell at him for it. You should never come out there, Jason. You know better than that.
Nah, I didn't make it.
He did not make it. He's going to leave it a little to the high side.
GG.
And that should be a concession.
Yep.
Although, and there it is. Jason concedes. Alex will concede. And officially, that is a 2-1 win for Young 46. So the number
bracket
one seed takes care
eliminated.
Of business.
And there we have it, our first finalist, Young 46.
And he will await the Shimi NF magnets. Go on, Jules.
I was just going to say, Jay Smithers, thank you so much for coming along with us and explaining lots of things to us. I mean, I felt that really it's been a good learning curve for me today. thank you so much. Are you going to be watching the rest of the matches today, or are you going to get out on the course?
Yeah. No. It's rainy and nasty here, so I'll be sitting here watching and hanging out. Yeah, it's gross.
Awesome.
You can stick with us for a little of this second match if you want. You know, I don't know.
I have literally nothing to do today. I have nothing going on, Jeff.
We might need to hear a little bit about Ishimi and F Magnets. Obviously, we know a lot about F Magnets, but Ishimi, I want to hear your breakdown as we start this second match.
I'm here for you, Jeff. Anything you need, I'm here for.
Excellent.
Rinse and robust beard oil. There you go, primer. That's what you need, buddy.
Oh my goodness, you weren't joking.
No, I'm not joking. No, you got to take care of it.
We also got some people.
Tell me where to get that. My husband's starting to grow quite a good one. So I mean, he's nothing like yours.
Oh yeah,
but, you know, on an amateur level.
Oh, you know what? But we got to start small. I mean, it's all about patience.
Like golf.
Like golf.
We also got some folks in the chat commenting on they like your hat, Jay Smithers. How much USGA gear? How much USGA gear do you have at this point?
Oh man, Jeff, it's pretty much all I have anymore. I like their clothes, and if you wait long enough with those USGA gift cards, you can get them at like 70% off. So you could just full wardrobe it.
It's just his closet is USGA gift card merch. But again, as we get ready to go with this match, Ishimi, what can you tell us about him, Jay Smithers, for the fans that might not know as well? This could be a big opportunity for him today. He'll need to knock off F Magnets and then Young 46 to get it all done. But what's going on with Ishimi?
Ishimi, I expect him to be a little more methodical than the majority of guys on here. When I've seen him play, he's tends to be on the slower side, but he's just going through all the progressions and trying to make the right choice, you know. So I think he's going to put up a good fight, though.
On the other side, F Magnets. He's been around so much. You've played him so much. How does Oakmont fit his game in this match play format?
He's just phenomenal. He's been phenomenal for a very long time, but Oakmont is a great equalizer. If you're off a little bit, as you've seen with Alex, missing the ding just a little bit, it's a very punishing course. So we'll see if Chris can, you know, hit a high. You want to be over 50% dings on this course for sure.
I'd just like to add that F-Mags won at Oakmont in our February championship. So he's feeling confident on this course, I'd say.
Oh, I'm sure he's feeling pretty confident. He can play this course as well as anybody. So we might see a crazy, crazy good round by him here.
Yeah, and he's having a very good year. He's obviously our current rating order of merit champion. It's very exciting to see what he's got. Also, I'd love
Absolutely.
It if he got into the final. You know, it'd kind of be a slight mini Ryder Cup kind of rivalry there, UK and the US.
Yeah, it'd be cool to see. It'd be cool to see for sure. But I wouldn't mind seeing Ishimi either. He's paid his dues. He's been in some e-tours, and he's a great player. So I can't root for either one here.
Well, there's a
no, that's fair enough. They're both your friends. That's completely fair enough.
Yeah, and Gavin is genuinely a great person. Like, Ed is a really, really nice person. I've talked to him a lot, so.
Josh, you not being in the semifinals while Young 46 and F Magnets are there kind of feels like a Federer and Djokovic in the semifinals, but no Nadal sort of situation.
Yeah, Jeff, I threw up a little bit. I'm not going to lie to you. But yeah, no, I know. I was pretty bummed, actually, because I was playing a really good final round. I just Number 15, man. I just blew it. Oh, Chris is on the ding already. You want to throw this long, ideally. You don't want to leave it up there.
Well, I'll tell you that G. Torrealba WGT in the chat, for what it's worth, Josh is saying that somebody should sponsor your beard situation. So you are getting that sort of buzz right now.
Jeff, I've been saying this for years. I don't understand why I haven't yet, but, you know, who am I?
It will soon, any day now.
I'm
Look at
Ishimi
31 here, over 7,000 in career earnings.
I will say it's interesting that he's playing on that resolution. Just he's got, yeah, I don't know if you've seen like his meter is like really long compared to everyone else. That resolution creates it a little more difficult to hit the ding.
But is the idea that it's if you get it right, it's more accurate? Or
I think it's more you get. You're more forgived, you know. If you miss, it's more forgiving. So, I mean, there's pros and cons to it, but it drives me nuts when I don't hit that stupid little white line down there.
Oh yes, I've experienced that many times, not hitting it.
It's so frustrating.
Tried to chip that in, and now a great opportunity for F Magnets to go one up on through one.
Yeah, this is why you don't want to leave it above this hole. It's just a sketchy downhill sliding little putt. There's another one of those, scenario based. You would just hammer this through all the break, or you kind of got to just lag it down there and make your par.
Recognized as one of the hardest holes in golf here, the first at Oakmont, and of course that's why it made it through to our virtual US Open, or best of the US Open holes in August, Jeff.
It did indeed, as did number 17 out here at Oakmont.
Yeah.
Yeah, this freaking hole is a beast. Number one is a nightmare. Especially that back right pin where they had it just now. It is very difficult to get a birdie back there.
Ishimi already one down after one hole.
Yeah, not the start. And then his driver just went way left. Got him in trouble. Oh, man, that was just that's just not fun. He didn't do anything wrong there. Champ just kind of kicked that ball over towards the rough while it was in the air.
It was mentioned that 18 was also in the virtual U.S. Open, 17 and 18, although we didn't get to 18 on our last match.
That's another nightmarish little hole.
It sounds like you love this course.
It's a love-hate thing, man. You know, it all depends on how the round's going, really. Sometimes you go out here and you can blister this course and you know, everything's a tap in. But then if you're out of position at all, the breaks and the greens are atrocious. And he's got such a hard shot here. He's coming over those bunkers, so he's going to land on a downslope that'll kick it to the right. It's, yeah, good luck, bud. I don't know what else to
say. Anyone. Yeah, we haven't seen
anyone.
Oh,
we got the
reeds.
That might go in.
Ooh. Oh, almost. I mean, hard to beat that if you're not going in.
He's got to make F-Mags putt this.
Oh, yeah.
You know, while I'm bashing Oakmont, this putt sucks. While I'm at it. While I'm in
the whole 15th hole, the first hole, the second green.
Mm-hmm. First hole, second green. Let's continue on. 15's absolutely atrocious. 18, terrible. There's got to be some other bad ones. Oh, there's a 299-yard par 3. Like, what is that?
Course designed by Henry Fones in 1904, Tom Fazio, Gil Hance, a couple renovations, restorations. You can go talk to them about all that.
Jeff, they didn't hit the ball 300 yards in 1904. Like, what are we doing with that hole?
I mean, when you talk about restorations, Jeff, they planted 5,000 trees a long time ago. They planted 5,000 trees at the turn of the century in order to beautify it. And then they removed, at the turn of the century, they then removed about 10,000. So returning it back to Fones' original design. Yeah, so they've sort of like not been able to make up their mind about the amount of trees they've put in. So they've added some and then they've taken away even more. And then as for the bunkers, there's 175 bunkers on the
This course has some bunkers in it. I mean, those bunkers on this hole are beautiful. This hole and four are awesome.
The church pews are gorgeous, yeah.
Yes, I love them.
Oh,
what a dandy.
Oh, my goodness.
Ooh.
Nearly went in. It stopped dead, didn't it?
Yeah, that was a good shot. He had a great number in. If I miss him, I see. I like how he's playing right now, though. He's going a lot like off spin shots. So he's looking for, you know, release and hole outs. Uh oh, Gavin.
There's also that risk smile over there. Scenario when you're one down. I guess it's kind of
For it. 100%.
Virtual adrenaline killing me.
Take a breath, Gavin. Genius. Take a breath. You're fine, buddy. It's early, and Oakmont has a lot. I mean, as we've talked about, every hole is absolutely a nightmare. So,
well, we can talk to Jason, who has just been experiencing every hole at Oakmont. He is going to join us in the booth. Hello, wow. Jason, Young 46. Well done. How you feeling?
Thank
I got to go. See you guys.
This front nine was kind of sloppy. There was winds on 6 and 9 were really weird. They were different than what they showed. And then bad shot decision on 5, tried to land it short and roll it in. So that was bad. Hi, Josh.
Hey, pick me. My hand's up. I want to say a few things to you.
Oh, okay. I thought you meant talk to the hand.
No, we're good. I think I was like 15 through 17, but could have been better. Well,
yeah, You got it together.
Yeah.
You know what? The shot on 5 is the one shot I wanted to ask you about.
I wanted to land it short. I literally had just had that playing a practice match play before. Like, same number, same win, like, identical. And it went really well. So I decided to play it again. And I catch a sprinkler head or something. And it just, I don't know.
Dude, that thing went really long. I don't like this
play. Gavin's not going for it. It's really, he just opened an eagle to beat him.
Yeah, he just conceded this hole, basically. Just hoping Mags doesn't make eagle.
Yeah, I don't love that play. Well, I guess maybe he can get on. But the angles, is it back left pin?
I can't see the,
it looks back left. So the angle's bad. That was a weird play.
Yes.
Sure this is going to go so well. It's interesting. He's playing on the 1920 by 1080.
That's what I was saying. I'm like, it's so hard to play on that.
Yeah, it's.
So, Jason, I noticed we had the privilege of having the camera on for the first time and noticed how poker faced you are. It's pretty impressive. Were you sort of, you know, like a swan, graceful on the outside and paddling furiously underneath? Or how are you feeling out there today?
I had some adrenaline on the first hole. My heart was pumping pretty good. I loved it. I liked the excitement. So yeah, it felt good. We had the back right pin, which is terrible. We had a left to right side wind. So it felt good to just stuff one in there to tap in first couple holes. That was nice.
Oh, this is so good.
Yeah, this is a nice shot.
This is so good. It might go. It's going to bend a little
bit. I'm confused why he didn't go for the other fairway.
Yeah, that was some great tactics there. Some pro moves using that other fairway, Jason.
Yeah, really confused, but...
you've got this time to sort of regroup and obviously prepare yourself for the final because you've got another maybe even 18 holes to play. What are you going to do in this time? And what have you sort of maybe learned or realized just playing the 18 holes then that you can kind of bring into the next round that you've got the final?
I was saying this morning when I was on stream this morning playing my warm-up rounds that my putting's just a hair off. My timing is just a hair off. You can see I missed some putts that felt like I should have made. The putt on 6, I've had that putt a decent amount of times, and the putt on 9. So I got to get my timing correct. It felt a little better on the back 9. I made that nice putt on 10. It was like 7 down 2. And then that kind of made things feel a little bit better. So it's got to – I mean, if I end up playing mags, which at the moment would be the case, you know, it's probably going to take 17 under at, you know, probably the lowest possible score to win.
Wow. Well, you shot 18 under here very recently.
Why?
Qualifier, you shot 53.
Yeah, qualifier, I shot 49, but it was an interesting round.
49?
Yeah. 49.
Oh, apologies. I had 50.
I'm sorry, it was a 50. It was a 50.
50.
Sorry. Yeah, 50. So you can go low here. Just need the right winds, right pins. I liked all the pins that we got last round, except for one. That's just a rough – I hate that back right pin.
On which hole?
On 1.
First.
One. I don't like 11, the back left on 11. Not a fan.
I liked it. See, I like that pin, and not a lot of people play that pin, so I felt like I would have an advantage. Then he drove it in the rough and got 25, and I'm like, ah, oh, man, that stinks. I was hoping it was going to be 30-40. But then I had that squirrely little 5-footer. I just didn't like it. Like, this pin is a good pin. If you get a right-to-left wind, it's a tricky hole. I think this is the more difficult pin here.
Just looking at Twitch, WGT Dean Bars just said, would you concede an eagle putt? It was really close to the hole.
I don't concede any putt that's 4.5 feet.
No, I didn't today. Alex had a couple 4-footers, and it helped me on 12. I had almost conceded that putt to him, and then he hammered it and missed it. So I was like, oh, wow. Got lucky there. 112,
so you were in 2 lines with that one.
Mm-hmm. I had my finger over the concede putt, but I was like, eh, you never know.
Oh, that was
never concede anything.
Jason, how does your concession strategy change as the match goes along?
It definitely gets tighter, right? But it's hole-based too, right? If they have a 3-foot putt that's straight up the hill and I know it's dead straight, I'll concede it. It doesn't matter what hole it's on. But if I know there's some break to it or I've missed it in the past, they're going to putt it. I don't care if it's a foot away.
Yeah.
This is match play.
I was explaining there was one where it was like putt. You were going to concede, but then you didn't concede. Yeah, so the thing I was telling them, like, sometimes, like, I'll wait 15, 20, 30 seconds, so they do all the work to line it up and then concede it, like, as a strat, you know?
I didn't do that as a strategy. I kind of felt like Alex was conceding some putts on purpose so I couldn't get a rhythm with a putter, maybe. Like,
I didn't think
that. Because there was a couple that tactical. Weren't super – I probably wouldn't have conceded them, and he did. And I'm like, this must be a tactic.
This not just a nice guy.
Yeah, no, I don't think he was doing it to be a nice guy. I know Alex. We're all good friends together, and we're not being nice to each other.
Hey, Jeff.
We're competitive.
Yeah.
Nobody's nice on this game, man. No, nobody.
And heartbeats for F-Mags on the 6th.
Hey, Chris is on today.
Yeah, that was a good shot. Pretty easy putt from there.
Josh, I think WGT has to put up one of those Instagram quote, tweet graphics. Just Jay Smithers.
Yeah, yeah.
Nobody's nice in this game.
Nobody. Nobody.
No.
I played with these guys long enough to know that if it comes down to it, they're not gonna be nice to you.
No.
That's a good shot, too.
Yep. I just feel like Ishimi's at such a disadvantage. He's playing on a resolution he's not used to. Like,
yeah.
That's hard.
Does seem like he's settled in.
Oh,
it's just slightly uphill.
Good putt.
Yeah, good putt.
Jason, that final hole that you played, the 17th at Oakmont, you were able to drive the green, and Josh here pointed out immediately that Alex wasn't going to be able to muscle it up there. Were you thinking about a hole like that in the back of your mind as you came down the back nine, that would be a pretty easy hole for you to win?
Yeah, ironically, I talked about it on my stream this morning. I said, hopefully, against Alex, I'm 2 up and we get to 17 and it's a headwind because different drivers. And it was. So I saw that and I'm like, yes. And we got the back pin. So I knew I could get on. I was pretty certain he wouldn't be able to. So it felt good. When I saw that wind, I knew, 99% chance it was over at that point. But I really wanted to make that eagle putt. Just heading into the finals would have been a nice touch.
You timed out.
I did. I didn't mean to. I felt bad.
You timed out.
That's literally the...
I know.
That's a bad time to time out. But, yeah, I wanted to make the putt. And then I didn't get it there. So there's that.
Yeah, all of that was good stuff. Oh, come on, Gavin. Got to get it together here, bud. They got tough pin on 7.
Yeah, I couldn't lose to Alex because, I've been playing some mental warfare all week with him, and I would have never heard the end of it if he'd have beat me. So that would have been bad.
No.
From, like, 20
you wouldn't
people.
Have been, you wouldn't have been welcome back for, like, a week.
It would have been bad. I wouldn't have came back for a week. Bad. This is a tricky pin.
F-Max.
Yeah,
it's
really tough.
Bad. I don't know. I don't know what ball he uses. I'm just a nightmare. You know what? While we're on the list of bad things on this course, Jules, Jeff, number 7 back left pin. Be gone with it.
Well, it's interesting, right? That we talked about some of the holes, and Young 46 was out there playing. Some of these holes were so generous, right in the middle of greens, and then some you get placed like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can
they
really
definitely have
tough
a different pin set.
Yeah, Mags's putt's not the easiest. It's going to be a pretty good left to right breaking putt.
Oh, Gavin's going to really not like his result here.
Oh boy. Good news is it's uphill.
Playing that flattish 8 into it, I don't know if that's possible.
No, not into that bowl. You gotta land it near the hole.
Right, you gotta go up a club and hit that 7. Ooh.
We saw Alex had a handful of these long putts against you, Young 46. A lot of left-to-right breakers. This is more right to left for a shimmy.
He made a couple of good putts. That putt he made on four, that's a kind of a weird putt to read. So I was feeling, you know, okay, I could possibly win that with the eagle putt, but he dropped that one. He made a good putt on one, two. I mean, he putted great.
16. His putt on 16 was big. Keep turning.
Oh, oh Gavin. Yeah. I thought it was over on 16 when I made that putt. I was like, okay, that again, that putt's kind of weird. It tends to break a little less than it shows. Maybe he doesn't know that, but he did. He did a Jay Smithers where you drop it in kind of at weight on the low side and it goes in still.
Oh, all I heard was he made birdie. I couldn't hear the rest of what you said.
It's called a Jay Smithers when you drop it on the low side.
I would have loved to drop a few on the low side against you today. That I'm sitting over here talking to Jeff and Jules drinking a coffee.
Yeah, three up. That's going to be hard to come back from.
Well, speaking of which, in a few minutes, we're going to let you go, Jason, as you get ready to play. But as you go into this final match against F Magnets, likely, as we're looking at this, you know, what adjustments are you going to make after going through one competitive play so far today on this course?
Long par three that you're talking about.
I need to putt better. That's about it. I felt like I was hitting the ding when I needed to. I was happy with the approach shots. Some of them didn't work out, but thought process was good. Execution was pretty good. So just need to drop putts. That's it.
Yeah, Jules, this is tough. Underpowered driver into this hole is really – oh, my God. Yeah, he's on.
Yeah, he's not missing the ding.
He's not. He's feeling it.
It's a critical moment for Ishimi.
Yeah, like I said, F-Mags, he'll be playing with some confidence. You know, he's one hit earlier on this
Pennsylvania
year.
Turnpike.
On this course. This course.
To the right, separating the eighth and ninth
good
hole.
To him.
I think he hammered that too. He hit that very hard.
This match is starting to get a little slippery.
Yeah.
I keep trying to click off the top tracer thing. It's driving me nuts.
Yeah, it's like kind of right there, middle-ish of the screen.
Yeah, it's right there. Hit it.
I don't like where he's aiming.
No, it's going to break pretty hard left to right.
Yeah.
Definitely. Oh. Maybe
or not.
Oh my gosh! What a putt!
Right down the center.
Just
wow! I just parred that hole and I didn't even play it.
Right? Yeah, I just parred it as well. That's huge. I mean, this is no guaranteed birdie. It has a little break to it, but
no, this is missable.
Playing, he's up. He's got the Jay Smithers glitch too, where you can see the lines.
That's right. That's right. $20.
$20.
Put that on stream for you guys.
I feel like he's gonna make it. He looks pretty locked in.
This putt. I don't like this putt.
No, me neither. It's got a lot of snap early.
It does.
Yep.
Ooh. Oh!
Ooh.
Hangs in that right side, and F Magnets is three up through eight. Young 46, we're going to let you go. You have a match to go prepare for, but we really appreciate the time, and there is a good chance that we will be talking to you later today.
Sounds good. Thanks.
Good luck,
appreciate
dude.
The time there from Jason. Josh, hold back one sec before we let you go. We're going to let you go in a few minutes as well. But
okay.
Before we do, let's start talking about F magnets here. You've seen him 8 holes in. You guys are just talking about how flawless he can be. We've seen it for so many years. When he is on, what makes his game so special?
Oh, he just knows. He knows all the courses. So if he's on and he's getting his yardages right and he's hitting the ding the way he wants to hit the ding, he's going to put himself in the right spot. And that the key to this game is I'd rather have 10 feet that's straight uphill than 5 feet that's bending downhill, you know. So when somebody's on the way he's playing right now, he's going to leave himself in the proper spot. And I think that's going to be the difference. If he can continue doing that, then that final match will be really, really tight. But he just made an error. He's going to get a kick long and right, and that's a big, big mistake. Come on, Gavin. Make it a game.
Saw this 9th hole cause some issues for Blaze Alex, especially in the last match. This was right around the time that you jumped in with us.
Yeah, it's such a tough hole.
It's a very big and undulating green, isn't it? Hi, gents. Sorry, I've just been having problems with my mic. Apologies.
Welcome back, Jules.
Thank you. But you're doing a fantastic job of filling my shoes here, Josh.
I was just trying to hold down the fort while you were gone.
I'm slightly worried I'm going to be out of a job soon. Oh, my goodness.
Should be with a dandy.
Beautiful.
That should be 2. He should get it to 2 going into the back 9, which is it's a big momentum booster for him. Confidence building shot that he just hit there.
He needed it if he's going to salvage this match.
Yeah. This putt is atrocious.
I mean, it's just I'm sitting over here. Oh, wow.
Yeah, he gave it a valiant run.
Yeah. Oh, that's disappointing.
Yeah, that a boy, Chris. You got to he can't. He's trying. He says, I don't want to be on this hole anymore.
He just wants to get out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah, just get me off this hole.
Yeah, onwards.
So for a brief moment, it looked like it might be, this match might go 4 up to F max through 8. Instead, it's just 2 up through 9.
Yeah. Well, I mean, big last 2 shots for Gavin with the big 25-foot putt and then that approach there.
Definitely makes it more exciting for the viewers. Ishimi still very much in it.
It'll be F-Max first to play, 133 in here.
Tricky green here that slopes front right to back left. Of course, he's hitting downhill.
That putt's going to be a challenge. The approach game was flawless from F-Max for about the first 7 or so holes, and now getting a little testy. Doors open for Ishimi again.
This game has a way of doing that. When you're on, you're on, but the second you get off, I mean, you can compile mistakes.
Sounds just like real golf, eh?
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, just got our first update on the first Ryder Cup match. The West is up 2 at the turn. Let's go, go team.
So what's the format then, Josh? Is it similar to the Ryder Cup? What were we expecting?
Yeah,
fourballs,
it's
foursomes,
the first format is alternate shots. So,
okay,
you know, they just alternate shots, yeah, obviously. Yeah. Yeah, and then the finals is 1v1 match play, similar to, you know, the, okay, Ryder Cup in real life.
Who's the captain of the East team?
Giannis, 1970.
Okay. So actually, you've actually cut the East over in Europe, because he's Greece, isn't he?
So yes.
Yeah. So it's a line, mm-hmm, straight down the middle of the European.
Yeah, we just drew a line down a map. Call it a day.
Excellent. Well, I'll be seeing how that unfolds.
F Magnus to try to get that 3-up advantage once again.
Slayer 911 FMO. Really? People actually watch this? LOL. Later. Peace. Oh, people are so rude for no reason, you know?
Slayer.
Yeah, Slayer. Go watch Call of Duty somewhere. Get out of here.
This up the hill for F Mags, but a big break.
No, we should send him some love and kindness. Oh, wow.
Some love and kindness. Yeah, yeah.
That's,
yeah,
the way.
Jules,
you kill them with
fit
kindness.
In too well here.
No, I mean, you say that and we laugh, and obviously there's this gritty competitive spirit amongst players. But what I would say is, though, as a community, this community is awesome. Everyone is so lovely and supportive. And, you know, there's banter, but it never crosses a line is what I would,
yeah,
say. And I've been impressed ever since I've been a part of it.
They'll tell you they love you as they're kicking you, you know. Apologize for, you know.
But it is a really nice community. Gaming is just, yeah, it's great.
Who's like the Tony Finau of the community? Just the nice guy who doesn't know how to have a bad bone in his body.
Thunderbird. I mean, Travis. Yeah, you know Travis. Yeah. You guys should know him.
Yeah.
He is, I don't know if I should let his nickname out there. All right, we call him Flanders. From The Simpsons, because he's so nice. You know, gee golly willikers.
Oh, bless.
Oh, Travis is one of the nicest, you know, people I've ever met. So, he's fantastic. So he catches a little crap for it, but he really is a good dude.
Yes, I think he just became, or had a new baby. I don't know whether it was his second, mm-hmm, but he had a new baby, didn't he, this year? And I think he won a couple of weeks after his wife had given birth. So yeah, pretty impressive. I think he was doing the night feed.
Yeah, he can play. He's been busy. He's been quite busy, like in his real life, but I mean, when he's playing on here, and he's really, really, really tough to beat as well. And he kills you with kindness while he's doing it. He's like, "Oh, that was a really good effort," and I'm like, "Duh, nice try." Ah.
Well, in our present match, this second semifinal match at the Match Play Challenge at Oakmont, big moment here. Ishimi, down 3, long birdie putt, down the hill.
This is bad.
That about sums it up.
That's all I got for this putt. It's just not good. Oh, what a putt. Mm.
He's made some outstanding putts to keep this match in check.
Unfortunately, at this point, he's more relying on Mags making a mistake. Being 3 down, he needs a couple mistakes from Chris here in order to get back in this.
And not there. Jay Smithers, we're going to let you go in just a moment, but we want to know, as you yourself are going on with the rest of the calendar year, the rest of the WGT season, we do have one more USGA Esports Grand Slam event. What are you trying to work on and tighten up with your game?
Finishing rounds. I think that's kind of been my a little bit of a knock. Sometimes I'll get out to really, really, really fast starts, and then it's almost like I get into like a little lull somewhere in the middle of the back nine, and it can be costly. That's you know, just stay aggressive is the new thing for me.
Well, someone as good as you can afford to be a little bit aggressive at times.
Well, we're going to do it.
Your experience. We're going to see what you're doing.
We're going to say things like, gee, golly, willikers.
maybe just be a nicer person. You know, maybe that's the
wow! Wow!
So, wow, Jeff, where did that curveball come from?
Yeah, I thought we had a great time when we met. I mean, you picked me to lose and then I won, so that was cool. That really started off our friendship in a great place, but it's all good. Work on being a better human being, Jeff says.
Thunderbird's out there in the chat right now, just trying to be humble right now. You know what I'm saying? You know I love you. You know I'm playing.
I got dogs on my coffee cup, man. How much better can I be?
Got six kids in the back you're raising right now.
Yeah, they're not.
Bottom line,
right now, thank you.
We miss you out here playing. Obviously came very close to being a part of this Final Four with Alex just getting the best you. He falls to Young 46 in our first semifinal. We're watching F-Magnets and Ishimi try to finish everything up, and we definitely expect to see you at the next match play event, Jay Smithers. We appreciate you being here, and do you have a pick to win it all at this point? You know, I've been wrong about my picks, but what's your pick right now?
If it holds, I actually, you know what? I'm just. It doesn't matter. I think Young 46 is going to take the tournament. He's been pretty intense about this tournament. He's been on it the whole time. He's been practicing, so I think he's just going to be unbeatable in that final round. Doesn't matter who his opponent is.
Okay,
all right, Jay Smithers, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
See you guys.
So nice talking to you.
We will talk to you shortly. I'll leave you with this. WG champion in the chat. Jeff is right. DB Stronghold. I try to tell him that all the time. So, you know.
Let me counter that before I go. Jules, keep Jeff in check for me. Obviously, something's going on with him today.
I will do my best, Jeff.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a great day, guys.
You too.
That's Jay Smithers. Such a
he came
dominant
in for a
force.
Long time. Absolutely.
Yeah.
But it was great to get his wisdom for so long, for over 18 holes. You know, it was really enlightening and interesting. And then, you know, and just getting to know what happens behind the scenes a little bit more.
F Magnus trying to match Ishimi out here.
I do get the sense that this match is just happening a little bit slower than the last one was. Taking their time a little bit more.
You can see F. Max's face there. That was not what he wanted in terms of especially the accuracy on that putt, but he just kind of held in the left side. The putter's been a little shaky on the last few holes for F. Max. He's grabbing the edges of holes right now.
Mags with the heartbeats here on 13 as the players are two-thirds of the way through their round. F Mags three up. Let's see if Gavin can change his luck in these next few holes.
This just 193. We've got some par threes close to 300 yards on this course today.
No heartbeats. It's landed in the middle of the green.
And this is the commentary right here.
Yeah. Bad time to miss late, absolutely. He knows it. Yeah, that's not a short putt.
No, if we had the advanced analytics on this, the proximity to the hole would be considerably different between these two players today.
True. And there's not huge amounts of break on it, but there's enough to feel a little nervous standing over this ball here, Jeff. Especially at this stage in the game for Gavin. As much. That's a costly putt.
And that will be a concession of the hole. Yeah. So now F Magnets goes four up as we reach the 14th hole. So four up with five to play wins this hole, and it's over.
Make Jason's coffee break, or whatever he takes break, that much shorter as he waits in the wings to see who he is up against in this final of the USGA Match Play Challenge at Oakmont. And it's interesting, Jeff, hearing Smithers' opinion on Oakmont, and he did have a little bit of he was whining a bit about this course. I think that's fair to say. But it's interesting because
what a shot!
Wow, that is awesome. Just at the right time.
But yes, go on with the point about.
Yeah, I think a lot of the players don't like this course, a bit like Kiwa, and they're choosing to, looking at all of their activity recently, they're all choosing to play on other courses, to practice on other courses. It's quite interesting. Even though they know where they're playing, they choose to sort of play and build up their confidence and get their iron or their timing perfected all on other courses.
So now this for F Max to negate that beautiful approach shot by Ishimi. Jay Smithers mentioned it. F Magnet's very methodical with everything that he does.
Paid off.
They'll concede that, and now four up with four to play. So Young 46 can start to stretch.
So there's a headwind here on 15. Quite a long par four. Church pew bunkers there on the left, and they're approaching a very large green with quite a lot of challenging movements on the green.
Yeah, into the wind as well, so we'll see. That's four iron out for F Magnets with this hole playing 193.
He's got the heartbeats. Boding
that
well
stays
for him.
Below the hole. Yeah. Challenging Ishimi to hold this out at this point.
That's got the heartbeats, though. My goodness. The response if he did. And it just slips by.
It's about as good as he could do. And he will make F bandits end this thing.
Oh, you would.
F Magnets takes this on the 15th, 4-3. And we have ourselves a final.
Oh, yes. It will be Young 46 against F Magnets for the match play challenge at Oakmont.
And Jules, they're going to take a moment. We're going to give F Magnets, make sure that he has proper time to take a rest, maybe grab a snack, maybe grab something to drink. As we get ready for this final, Young 46, there were maybe a couple screws loose that he was honest about as that match went on. He criticized his own putting, said he needs to tighten that up. F Magnets on that front line looked dominant, got a little bit loose as that went on, but it seemed like he really slammed the door and got back on.
That's right, he did. And if you think he smoked his opponent way more than Young 46 did, even though Young 46, you just saw him looking confident all the way and you didn't see a kind of dip in his form like you did with F Mags. But it's a really hard one to call. That's all I can say. I couldn't possibly call it.
You're going to have to call it. Broadcast it.
You've got two Trojans of the game now competing for this particular title. It's going to be great, and I wonder how many. Okay, let's hazard a little guess. What hole do you think that the match will be ended on? Go on, you say a hole, and I'll say higher or lower. How about that?
I think this is going all 18. I think this is going to be. I don't think that we will. I'm going to be this bold, Jules. I don't think we'll ever see anyone lead by more than one up in this match.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, and I can totally see where you're coming from. So I'm going to say that maybe on the 17th. So I'm going to go one hole lower than you. So let's see who's right there.
We haven't seen 18 yet, right? So we want to get to it. We want to see everything the whole way through. And I think, you know, Alex really came out firing in that match against Young 46. And they were, I believe, through the first four holes, they were tied up. And it was feeling like that was going to be a match that no one was going to give the other opponent an inch, as we'll get to that other, as we show the highlights actually from that match. These were some eagles that were made on that fourth hole, and then it turned after that for Young 46.
They were neck and neck, and it was hard to call just until right at the end. Just Alex started to, I mean, even still here on 16, you know, halving the hole.
In the other match, Ishimi against F Magnets, there were just too many long putts that Ishimi was giving himself.
Yeah, it's interesting. Josh also was talking about the way he had his stroke line at the bottom, that it was slightly wider and could potentially be a little bit more forgiving, and whether sort of the way he was playing was a bit more defensive and he was maybe feeling a bit more vulnerable in his game. I don't know.
There's some of the finishing there by F Magnets. I mean, we're going to get two of the giants of this game. And it's match play, so it's a little bit different. And maybe something for F. Mags that we're seeing him play with confidence. You know, it's a different mindset, right, Jules, when you're thinking hole by hole, hole by hole. Some of those stroke play events that we've seen, for example, the last stroke play event we had, the virtual U.S. Open, Jay Smithers went out, put up a low score. Everyone had to think about that throughout the day. Now these guys, they're coming out here. You can just think in terms of tactically, how do I get past this hole? How do I get past this hole? Although at the same side, we saw Young 46 knowing that he had 17 in the back of his mind with his driving ability. So there's a mix and match there with the strategy.
Definitely. And I think, you know, as I said before, I do think F. Mags is feeling confident on this course, having come off the back of a win here. He's also the current reigning Order of Merit champion. So he knows he's in good form. He's coming in this season in the best form he's ever been in. It's been surprising that he hasn't yet won the Order of the Season Ender. Or being the champion of the season, and he is now, and he's finally got that title. So I think that's definitely giving him a little bit of swagger going into this kind of match. But yes, match play is a different ball game altogether, I think. And you know, we've been hearing all about the behind the scenes tactics and conceding putts, not conceding putts, the reasons why. A lot of that's going to play into it, and that's stuff that they're not necessarily as experienced with. It's going to be very interesting and exciting to watch. And also two fantastic players, lots to learn off them.
See a lot of banter right now in the chat. We want to hear on Twitch, on YouTube, who do you think is going to win this match? Also, we should mention, Jules, you know, big difference from the virtual US Open with really fast greens, tough pin positions, wind whipping. In this match play format, the wind has been a little bit more generous. The pin placements have certainly been more accessible, and that leads to players, Young 46 and F Magnets, are going to go into this, and they have to know there will be points they'll have to get aggressive if they want to win holes. You have to win holes out here with birdie or eagle today.
And that's what makes match play so much more fun, is that you can afford to be aggressive in some instances. And yeah, with conditions like this that are constantly changing, you've got some pin positions that are really, really tricky, like that front right over on the first. But then you've also got some which are remarkably, much, much easier to contend with. And also, you know, the wind wasn't playing havoc with their game, as it often does during tournament conditions. So yeah, let's see what these guys have got. And here we are. It started. The final is underway of the USGA Match Play Challenge here at Oakmont. F. Mags teeing off. Bit of a tailwind, but not an extreme tailwind, as I was just saying.
Couple early messages exchanged. As these two guys have faced off many times before, virtually, in person, on multiple continents, you name it.
That's right, F-Mags dialing in from Brazil. And here's Young 46, scoring average 49. Greens in reg, 95.63. That is ludicrously high. And of course, representing Cobra Kai.
Closing in on 80,000 in career earnings. It's going to go 8-iron here with some helping wind.
And he's got the heartbeats here on the first. I think that's... He's not sure about it. Not entirely happy, but it didn't look too bad. Certainly didn't look too far from the hole.
F Magnets on the other side. How about that? 205,000 plus in career earnings. He is the godfather of this game. Been at it so long, and again trying to establish himself as the top dog.
And if this is a mini Ryder Cup, he's representing Europe.
Wanted a little bit more on that. I think I stand by what I said earlier, Jules, that really F-Max, Young 46, Jay Smithers, it's the Nadal, Federer, Djokovic of this game. Anytime you can break up that big three,
yeah,
the rest of the field is happy.
And I'm opening this up to Twitch. Who's the Alcaraz, guys? Who do you see coming up through the ranks and is going to start his own sort of league?
And then who's the Medvedev that makes you laugh?
Yeah, true.
That's just off for F-Max. So early, the door is open for Young 46. One up.
Don't birdie this hole often. So, good stuff.
How about that? Yeah. It is a hole that they all dread. One of the hardest opening holes in golf. So, he is... I think I could hazard a guess. He's pleased at that. Despite the poker face.
No! How did that not clear, man?
As opposed to that shot. So here's F-Mags hoping not to do the same thing here on the second.
That is ripped straight down the fairway.
All right, you gotta hit a little shot here.
Definitely got the advantage coming into this hole.
Good number, but not a good number.
You can see that 40 to 50% lie in the second cut.
Definitely privileged to hear this personal commentary going on with the players.
And that is expertly played off the ridge.
I'll take that. All things considered.
He'll take that, meaning he'll putt uphill, even if that wasn't in heartbeat range.
Oh, he's got the heartbeats, though.
And he gets it!
Oh, my goodness. Wow. That's
magnets.
One... that is one
that's
way
an eagle.
To bounce back from the first hole. His honor. On the third, all square.
Couple of... quick starts for these guys. F magnets working quickly. You're not going to see any emotion out of him.
No, silent and deadly. Nothing vocal either.
That'll at least make Young 46 feel some relief about missing the tee shot, right, Jules? Even if he hit the fairway, it probably wouldn't have made a difference. As we take another look at this from 40 yards out, F-Magnets.
Yes, oh, that's just pure class. Brilliant to watch. It's
can we make it back-to-back, Eagles?
Young 46's reaction to that. Oh, now that would be amazing. Well, we got the heartbeats. Not quite.
F. Magnet shakes off the first hole. Two good approaches in there. We might see two concessions.
Now, is he doing what Smithers was saying? No, he is going to make him. But up. Yes, it's the right thing.
Okay. Is it Young 46 maybe pulling a page out of Alex's book, not letting F. Mags putt as well, not letting him get in rhythm? Jules, you highlighted this hole off the top.
Yes. But they got the headwinds here, which they didn't, I believe, before in the last semi-finals. Yeah, a bit of a sigh there from Young 46. But he's choosing this interesting route, using the other fairway.
That's the route that we've seen for the most part. F. Mags used that route in his first round match and actually made an eagle, but maybe into the wind choosing not to do so.
So that is actually an interesting play. He decided to give up on that eagle. Well, not give up on the eagle, but he's chosen to play conservatively.
He's right in his eagle range, Jules. I don't know what you're talking about. He's right around that eagle spot that he had on the second hole. But this is critical right here. Young 46 did decide to take this route. You expect him to pull out a three wood here, and he's trying to hit this ball into the wind. And now he's trying to figure out if he doesn't have enough. It looks like this is probably going to be a layup. It's going to just trickle on, but not even. And now this is where you'd be looking in real life and saying you would expect two players to play to comfortable distances. So that's F. Magnets with a sand wedge in his hand.
There he goes
to the 60. And that's where things get interesting. We just saw him make an eagle from 40 yards. This 66, a bit more of a swing. He can go almost full swing here. A little bit less. Some folks in the chat were asking about these punch shots. Where do you do a punch shot like this? This is Young 46 taking that opportunity.
Amazing, no heartbeats. But he's pretty close to the hole. So here is F. Mags putting for a birdie here. Didn't manage to get that eagle. And he's got it.
A very conventional play on this hole.
Ah, the putt's been conceded.
Yep.
Yeah, I was wondering. I was just waiting to see, holding my breath for that.
They're moving fast. See how far F. Mags gets this driver down to that rough at the end of this fairway with the wind. about as far down as you can get it.
Yep, same position as the last time for Young 46.
Wedge game in. You can hear Young 46's calculations in the works. Helping wind, maybe not the time you want the helping wind.
Here he goes. No heartbeats. It's online. He's overshot it just a bit. Yeah, he's surprised at that.
Kind of tanked it. And great opportunity for F-Max, who has been strong with the wedges.
Bird's eye view of this hole, Jeff. It looks very, it's like tribal markings with all the shapes and design of the bunker. Bunkers, should I say. I mean, there's like 20 bunkers on this hole. Amazing. Now, F-Mags with the heartbeats. Oh, that is almost a tap-in.
It's been outstanding so far, within 100 yards. And now Young 46, he's going to need to make this. And here's the aggressive play that we talked about that you can go with in match play. We'll see how much break Young 46 really gives this, as opposed to just the pace that he needs to put it on to hold its line. Nope.
Oh, how did it go? Just I.
This makes zero sense.
Yeah, I think this hole's bamboozled him. He was very surprised at where he pitched it. That putt. Just got to leave that behind and move on to the next. So F-Mags is now one up. On the 6th, the first par 3 on Oakmont.
And for these guys, it's 201 into the wind. Get you double trouble of F-Max here. You heard Young 46 share that he hit 4-iron. So we'll see if Young 46 adjusts based on that. I know some folks out in the chat have been remarking about how these two players play different golf balls. That's a 3-iron for Young 46.
Ooh.
He got way too much of it.
Yeah.
Come on, Jason. Good Lord.
Now that is a tricky putt.
Jules, he said the quiet part out loud. He said, all right, he used a 4-iron. Young 46 went to the 3-iron and again pops an approach shot long.
There's something about the judging of distances right now for him. for these last two holes. No, missed it high as well.
5 and 6, get me again. Jeez, okay, yeah, man. Easy holes.
Two holes in a row. And similar mistakes.
I said at the beginning of the match, my bold prediction was that no one would go more than one up. But on the sixth hole, F. Magnets, who lost the first hole, he gets to two up.
There you have it. That was your commentator's curse for Young 46. Okay, one third of the way through their round. F-Mag's two up on the seventh at Oakmont.
Two holes.
I believe this was the hole that Jay Smithers mentioned. Everything moves a little left to right on the green. So you got to factor that in with that right to left wind.
Yeah. And it's a hole where Young 46 is really going to have to regroup and just park those last two holes aside, forget about them. And approach this with some confidence and keeping his cool here.
Yep. Two good shots. Young 46 wanted that to roll out a touch more than it did.
It did stop dead, yeah.
And now this is going to have some break.
Yeah.
This is not good.
Not the putt that you want to be faced with after the two holes that he's had.
Terrible.
Oh, that is disappointing.
What are you doing, man? Jeez, oh Pete, I'm sucking. All right, we're gonna have to make a heck of a comeback.
And there it is, that miss again.
That's the viewpoint that F. Magnets had of it. Didn't sound like Young 46 was sure F. Magnets would make this coming back. Has a little bit of a double break to it. He does get it. Three up.
It.
F Magnets.
Not yet at the turn. Still quite a few holes to play.
And this a challenge. 299 yards downhill. Just a slight breeze left to right for these guys. But you're likely taking driver with this wind. And trying to dial your driver up to the right distance. Probably not going to see F. Mags go all the way back.
That big bunker to the left of the green and the fairway is called Sahara because it's about 100 yards long.
And again, deep from Young 46. which means another downhill putt. By the way, Jules, I don't want to know what sort of wildlife is hanging around in the Sahara bunker.
I think it depends on what time of year, Jeff.
I've watched enough nature documentaries. See a lot of movement in this putt for Young 46.
Yeah.
Needs to find something.
So with the last three missing short or missing high. Same again.
And just kind of...
just wasn't quite enough.
We got... it looks like another Young 46's camera froze again, Jules, and I think that expression he had is...
no, I think he's just frozen.
Might just be the expression that he's had for the last few yeah. holes as F magnets with a chance to get to four up through eight. Big breaker, but again, uphill for F magnets. He can put some pace on this.
Yeah. And with being four up, you can could just start to relax a little bit. And he can. F-Mag's four up, moving into the ninth hole.
Four up, he's won five of the last seven holes. This hole has been tricky all day for the competitors. Tee shot pretty straightforward, but that with that pin on the front right... you already start to have to think about the approach shot way back on the tee. Young 46 wasting absolutely no time. It's going to be F magnets first. Jules, this wind is helping the players on this hole. We've seen a lot of right to left winds. I believe first two matches we saw winds off the right. Wind off the left here at least gives you some bailout in the middle of the green.
Yeah, this green severely undulates. Can bamboozle some players. It's also the practice putting green for members at the club.
Very unique part about this Oakmont Country Club. Opened way back in 1904. Actually opened...
03, I think.
03, 1903, excuse me. A lot of spin from Young 46 there. The benefit of where he ended up, he's got the longer putt, but he's got the uphill putt.
Both these players are highly experienced, but they're also intuitive players because of their experience and how much and how well they've done and what they've achieved in this game. So if Jason can just use that experience, brilliant, rather than getting riled about his last few holes. And that's a great way to bounce back.
And that's
finally
a birdie.
A putt going in. Yeah.
Yeah. Schmales in the chat was asking, when was the last time that Jason made four pars in a row?
Yeah, exactly.
Pressure shifts to F mags. That could be a big way for Jace, for Young 46, excuse me, to salvage just three down off the front.
Yep, a change in momentum for him.
Twenty-five seconds to go. Jules, I wouldn't be surprised to see F magnets take take this all the way down.
Yeah,
might even use the timeout here.
They've got two warnings, and it's three strikes and you're out. So, you know, that by all means use it when you got it if you need to.
He uses it all the way to 55 seconds.
Oh my goodness, that was the turns. How about that?
That was
an emotional roller coaster, that part, wasn't it?
An outstanding effort, but Young 46 takes that and runs immediately to the 10th tee, teeing off quickly. Jules, you look at that front nine holes, five holes won by F Magnets, two by Young 46. So only two holes on those first nine were halved. So these players going blow for blow, still a three up advantage for F Magnets.
Yeah, these next couple of holes are going to be a real indicator of how Jason will then approach the rest of the round and how aggressive he'll be, I think. So it looks like a bit of a downhill lie here. Tricky lie. That fairway sloping from right to left. Not got the heartbeats.
Yeah, got the ding, but not the heartbeat. And again, Young 46 told us in between his matches, the putting was where he wanted to improve. But the approach play has just been slightly off, slightly long for much of this round.
Oh, heartbeats for F Mags.
That's really good. Really good to set up potentially a birdie putt to get him right back to four up. Again, the challenge is to Young 46, looking very much like the last match we saw from Ishimi. Constant long putts.
Quite amusing chat in Twitch here. Jason is going to have to blink at some point today.
Too much pace on that. And how about that? F Magnets, they both concede, so F Magnets wins the hole, goes four up with eight to play. Obviously, these guys have the utmost respect for each other, Jules, but there aren't that many holes left to go. So to concede at that point.
Smithers would have completely screwed both of them. Or maybe there's that sort of desperate kind of yearning to move on to the next hole, get it done.
It's a picturesque drive there by F Max. Young 46, we've gotten some great frozen expressions from him.
Oh, did that go in the ditch? Is that playable? Oh, it's playable from there.
It's going to be in the rough. Very similar to what we saw in the second hole. Mm.
Mm. And he's got the heartbeats. That promising sound. Not leaving himself something that's concedable. If that's even a word.
Well, we can make a word in this game.
Thanks, if you allow it. Thank you. Appreciate it. So, Jeff, how do you feel about Justin Thomas being chosen for the team? I've said it. I've been dying to ask you that question.
It took how many holes did it take before?
Took 2.5 hours.
You know, everyone has an opinion on this. That's a good shot from Young 46. And I think that I was just talking to someone yesterday about. I think that too many American fans tend to look at it as it's an, you know, in our traditional team sports, we have all-star teams in every league that are the best players that season. You know, kind of like at the end of the Premier League season, right? There's a starting 11 that's named. But that's not what this is. And I think a lot of people think that's what it should be. It's about, you know, how do you get the best players on the team, the best players in the world that are going to be the best players right now. And that goes into a lot of the decision-making and also a lot of the decision-making that Europe has made over the years with Ian Poulter, with Henrik Stenson, with Sergio Garcia, Justin Rose, names that have been captain's picks in the past as Young 46 knocks this on in.
He knows how important that was to change that momentum. And
names that have been, right. I just want to lock up my opinion there, Jules. That,
no, you know, please. I did ask. I apologize.
You need those. you need to sometimes just go on feel and throw out the stats and throw out everything and and who are the best players and who are you going to look like 6 months from now? You know, it was ludicrous not to put on the team, and I think you're seeing it from JT this week, and I think that you're going to be seeing that over the next couple of months as he rounds back into form, that the idea of not having a guy who is transcendent among his era would just be foolish at the end of the day.
So you're saying you definitely, if you were captain, you would definitely have picked him.
I would. I think the U.S. team has so much talent. You have players like Keegan Bradley and Cameron Young, who you had to leave off, Tony Finau.
You kind of feel sorry. Yeah, you kind of, your heart, you know, a bit of a Maronk situation there with Bradley. A little bit, not quite as much, but yeah, kind of feel for him a little bit.
Exactly, and I think that, to me, the interesting part is the U.S. President's Cup team a year ago, Will Zalatoris got injured, Kevin Kisner ended up being the 12th pick, and it was sort of a, how do we even find a 12th player for this team? You know, and Billy Horschel was the 11th pick. I think that any of those guys that I mentioned, if, you know, they had this season last year, they would have been on the President's Cup team. If that sort of season had moved a year later, then those players would be on the Ryder Cup team. You know, it's just, sometimes it's just the luck of the draw of when you have your strong season and when you don't. I mean, think about how different Team Europe would have looked 12 months ago.
Oh, goodness. Yeah, I mean, it would have been a real, I wouldn't have felt as positive as I probably do now.
It would have been, it would have been scrapping and clawing for some to fill out a roster.
Oldbury was, exactly. I mean, you know, he was just a complete curveball from nowhere, out of nowhere, 77 days turning pro, no major championship history, and he's made the Ryder Cup team. Yeah, it's pretty insane. You couldn't write this stuff.
How about that shot from Mags all the way back there?
That's not close, is it? Let's just see how far that is from the hole.
Little punch shot coming for Young 46. We saw this earlier today.
Oh, he's got the heartbeats. Oh! Oh, it just stopped dead like a lot of his approach shots today. But that is virtually a tap-in.
An impressive third shot there. And now we'll see how F. Mags plays this shot. He can win the hole.
But he also, It's nice knowing that he doesn't need to. Shaking his head there. He knew it. He knew it, even though it was pretty close. Yeah. Some frustrated sound there coming from F-Mags' microphone. So having
a mix of
that
noises
hole,
coming from that microphone. Yeah. As we go to a par three, how about this, Jules? Right into the wind. We've seen this from a couple par threes today. But F-Mags just letting it rip.
Yep. Looks like it's an uphill putt.
I'll be honest, that's a little bit of a reach for a heartbeat.
Yeah. I'm inclined to agree with you.
Might be an opening for Young 46 to chip away.
Oh. Well, that's a little bit closer. Yeah, no way is that much going to be conceded.
No.
Surprised it even came up with the option of it. Yeah, 9 foot. He's got a nice cushion, but these next few holes are crucial if he is to cement the title.
Okay.
Ah.
Don't go anywhere quite yet. Young 46 is blasting this in the back.
And it's in. Yep. So, interesting hole. F-Mags moves to 3 up.
A little fight in Young 46 as we get to this par 4. With this win, this is going to play as a very short par 4. And important to avoid the rough there. Getting close to the green for Young 46. And F Magnets in the rough. These players get aggressive with the driver, trying to get it up to the mouth of that green, and problems come into play. F-Magnet's playing a full shot, not a flop shot.
And it's paid off. That's close. Didn't get the heartbeats, but
Jules, you know what you got to be thinking if you're Young 46 after that shot.
Oh yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Flagstick is out. This is going to be aggressive. Hawkeye Kid in the chat, smelling pitch in. Toward 111, hole out possible. And Young 46.
No heartbeats.
Yeah, he'll tell you that was off. with the accuracy especially.
Not a bad attempt, though, Jeff.
Not bad, and now you have to make F magnets putt this.
Yeah.
You have to hope. You have to hope down the stretch for some yips.
No yips here, Jeff.
No. 10, 15 years F Mags playing this game, you don't see yips often.
No, no. He's a pretty cool customer, F Mags.
So F Magnets 3-up with 4 to play. And F Magnets win of the hole would end the match. But Young 46 is back in rhythm.
Oh yeah, I wouldn't put a comeback past this guy at all. F Mags in his traditional Copacabana style attire, reminding us where he's dialing in from, Brazil, with his tropical palm trees.
Some conversation in the chat from Primer Lance and Babzilla about a match that Young 46 and F Magnets had years ago where Young 46 came back from 3 down with 4 to play, but they noted that that was at Marion, not Oakmont.
Okay. Oh, and Jason pitched in on the last. Good memories, guys, and thank you for that.
Two heavyweights going at it. It's a heartbeat, but not a gimme. Not a gimme for sure for Young 46 on that slope. So F Magnets, if I'm reading him correctly, Jules, he is looking to find anywhere on this green that is going to give him an uphill putt within 12 feet.
Let's see what he's got. I'd be interested to see how play would be affected if you were aware of what your opponent could do, or you could see your opponent or not in a match play event.
That's a great shot by F Magnets. He's going to make Young 46 potentially need to make this putt to continue the match. 7 feet, slightly downhill, not a whole lot to this.
And he's got it. Keeping the dream alive.
Got to make F Magnets putt everything out at this point. Really not much to this. Didn't even worry about changing the line. So 3-up with 3 to play is F Mags as we make it to 16. Young 46 needs to win the final 3 holes. This is a par 3 downhill but into the wind. And this is interesting, going to 3-iron, a little less club. He's been airmailing today.
He's got the heartbeats. Another one with not much runoff to it.
Yeah, that was dialed up nicely. Just took a touch off that 3-iron. Might have needed the full shot. And
I think that
putt's
preferable,
yep.
Though. Looks like it's below the hole, right? So at this stage, you want to keep the putt simple.
Yeah, if you're F Mags, you might be thinking of trying to end up in the same exact place. And that's just about what he does. A little bit on a side slope. Young 46, straight forward up the hill.
Yep.
That's well done. And now, he'll await this F Magnets to try to take the title of the match play challenge at Oakmont on the 16th hole of our championship match. He's three up. And this would make him three up with just two holes to play. Enough in this to raise the hairs on your arms just a bit.
I'm waiting to exhale.
And you can now, as F Magnets is the champion of Match Play Challenge at Oakmont, part of the USGA eSports Grand Slam Series. What a performance for him. 3-2 in your championship match over Young 46. He's been at this for so long, Jules, and adds another title to the list.
Absolutely. A truly deserved winner. He played very, very well. There were some moments of magic in both of his rounds today in the semis and the finals. He did really well. I think Young 46, he did have some moments where he was unlucky, some unlucky reads, some unlucky distances. I think some distance control with his wedges definitely put him at a disadvantage. Those holes 5, 6, 7, those parts particularly on those holes, I think he'll be cursing this evening. But well done, F-Mags. He was good, consistent, and did not make mistakes.
Yeah, for sure, Jules. I would say, you know, Young 46 told us it was going to be about the putter. That's what he had in mind. But what it really ended up being about was the approach play. You saw it in the chat. Tons of shots long, was misjudging distances, making too many pars. And F Magnets just wasn't going to slip. Slipped maybe a little bit on the first hole, made a par at the first. But from then on, he was flawless. We're going to bring in the champion right now, F Magnets. You know, we were just saying it. I mean, congratulations, Chris, on the victory. But the second hole there, you lose the first hole in the championship match against Young 46, and then you hole out for eagle from 40 yards. How did the momentum change right there?
Hi, Jeff. Hi, Jules. Hello. I suppose that was important because if you get down early, then Oakmont is the kind of course where, I suppose you saw in the first round as well, that you can just keep your foot on the accelerator and the other guy just can't catch up. So, of course, it's a lucky bonus when a shot like that goes in. But it was needed.
Absolutely. I love the mind games thing, you know, that Josh, that Smithers has been talking to us about, you know, sort of certain tactics. And with you, you know, it's, I'm going to give up the first hole to get the guy really comfortable, and then I'm going to come in and rip it up. You did so well. Were you feeling like all the parts of your game really come? But did you feel that, you know, all your everything came together today?
In the first round, yeah. Not so much in the second round. I missed a few too many putts there. But I was hitting the ball well through the day, which is good. Didn't feel too tired in the second match, which happens sometimes when you have to play back to back like that. And I suppose
yes,
I got
you didn't
a bit
get much of a rest,
well.
Did you, in between the two rounds?
But that's good. When you're playing well in the first round, you have a good rhythm and you're hitting the ding, you want to go straight home and play the second one. It's just the 5 minutes in between the game, then you start to feel a bit tired suddenly. and you hope that the momentum can keep going. But even though I parred that first hole, they did hit a nice ding into it, so that's kind of a confidence builder, even though I'm one down.
For you, so many people in the chat talking about how difficult Oakmont could be. What makes it a course where you can showcase some of your strengths as you take home this $750 prepaid gift card prize and $500 USGA shop prize?
Woohoo! Mrs. Magnets will be happy. Lots of shirts for her and stuff from Amazon, probably. I think the only difference between me and the other guys is I like to play a low spin ball at Oakmont. And the other guys all play the top of the range high spin balls. And even though that gives them a better chance to get at some of the tight pins, like the front pin at number 9, and also 18, where we didn't get to the back pin at 18, I think the other holes, it gives me better distance control. And you saw that a little bit in the second round. I think my shots were generally going closer to the correct distance, and a few of Jason's were spraying around a bit, which... if you get the distance wrong and you leave yourself 4 or 5 yards away from the hole at Oakmont, you're dead, really, because the putts are so difficult.
But your putter was hot today. It worked. Not hardly any mistakes you made, I felt.
Well, I had 3 pars in the second round. I mean, usually if you do that against Jason, you'll lose. So I did get a bit lucky to, I think he had a sort of spell in the middle of the round where we're just spraying shots strange distances. Probably he couldn't work out what was going on, and neither could I. It's very strange to see somebody going 4 yards, 5 yards long or short or whatever. Just unusual.
Yeah, and Jason Young 46 is in the chat right now. He's congratulating you on playing a great round. He also described his own round as being a four-letter word that we're not going to say on here. And as you kind of go back and forth, you guys have had so many battles and you see him struggling. How does that adjust your mindset, just knowing that maybe you're thinking things are going to be really tight going on, and then you get out to that early advantage?
I think it's best to ignore that, because especially the closing holes at Oakmont, it's very easy to hit quite good shots there and still make pars. So even if you're maybe 3 or 4 holes in front, you can mess up 14, you can mess up 15, you could mess up 60, you could easily lose a 17 to an eagle, and you can mess up 18. All the holes are parable without hitting hugely bad shots. So I think you just ignore what the other guy's doing, just try and play your shot as best you can, and just do that every time. And whatever the state of the match, whether you're up or down, just get on with it.
Well, I know we're not supposed to be biased at all or anything like that, but I'm from Fulham. You're from Fulham. Well done for representing Fulham today. What are you going to do to celebrate?
I'll come and visit you in a couple of weeks in Fulham if you like. I'm going to be there.
We can have a little party. Oh, nice. Let's do it. Let's do it. I'll do a big welcome home party and, all singing, all dancing.
Thank you kindly.
Well, I think that what Jules is getting at is this might be an omen for Europe going into the Solheim Cup and the Ryder Cup. I know we heard,
Jason Smithers. That hadn't crossed my mind at all.
Talking about some of the match play competition. Did you feel like you're carrying Europe in these situations, especially in match play?
I have played in a lot of these Ryder Cup things in the past. With the WGT community, but because I'm on holiday this time, I'm not going to be playing, so I'll just have to wish the other guys good luck. I'm not even sure which side of the world I'd represent, because I could be on either of them, really. Whichever side doesn't want me the most, I'd play for the other side, I suppose.
Well, I'll tell you what. There were some people that wanted to get the best of you here this week. They did not. As F. Magnus, you are the champion once again in another USGA Grand Slam event. This, the Match Play Challenge at Oakmont. So congrats. And I would imagine that we will be seeing you in the final USGA eSports Grand Slam event of the year, another Match Play event. Again, congrats.
Thank you kindly. Yeah, I hope to be there.
Well done.
Pinehurst. I like Pinehurst. One of the only players in the game that actually likes Pinehurst. And just before I go, say a big thank you to you guys. Thanks to WGT, the USGA, SLG for putting the event on. A big shout out to DB Stronghold, who's been the defending champion all year. Well done to him for last year. And to Don as well. Just commiserations, because nobody shot the better score than him in the bracket finals, and yet he didn't make it through, which is very unlucky. But Just say hello to him. And well done on a good tournament.
Well said. Thank you.
Thank you for all of that, FMAX. We'll send that to Master Hacker, Don, as you were talking about. And we will see. Maybe it'll be the two of you guys going at it at Pinehurst. So thank you again to FMAX, and congratulations on this title here, part of the USGA eSports Grand Slam. You know, he's done so many of these interviews, Jules. He's been a champion so many times, but I think they're just showing also the great character of F Magnets and why he's been such a fixture and an important part of this community for so many years now.
Oh, he is, and listen to him. You know, he's talking. I mean, gosh, talk about being well-versed and well-prepared. You know, he's saying it's all his right thank yous, like an Oscar speech. It's all prepared. Here's one I wrote earlier, you know, and mentioning, of course, Master Hacker, who didn't make it through, who, you know, is a massive Trojan of the game. And, you know, he's just a pure class act, F-Mags, and he keeps his cool. He doesn't get riled up. And all of his experience and his internal calmness paid off today. And here he is, the winner.
I think a little bit of a play better moment, too, in terms of, you know, so many people complaining about Oakmont or the tough courses. He said, F-Magnet says, give me Oakmont, give me Pinehurst, give me the tough courses and see if you can come out and beat me there, because that's what a guy like him, a veteran who's done so much, it seems like that's the attitude, and that's what you have to have in some of these events.
Well said, Jeff. Absolutely. You know, you can complain about stuff, but at the end of the day, how do you deal with something? Do you sit down, think about it, and work hard at it? He's done all of that. He kept his cool. And, you know, he, like he said, there is a little bit of a perfect storm that happened today. Jason did have a wobble, I'd say, with distance control on those 3 to 4 holes, and he said his putting was a hair's breadth off, and he was absolutely right, it was. So yeah, it's that perfect storm. But F-Mags, and not to take anything away from F-Mags, he had all parts of his game there, he played with it, and he did so well. Congratulations to him, hugely.
Jules, let's take a look at some of these shots that made today so impressive as we had our final four coming at us. We had a champion in F Magnets, but how'd we get there? First match of the day plays Alex against Young 46. Those were two. These are
first
two
eagle.
Yeah, two eagles on four. This match was pretty even to start.
Yes, it was. It was close. It was. You couldn't have called it through the first nine. No way. And even there, here you go. This is his birdie on 16 that played havoc with our nerves a little bit. But yeah. I mean, F-Mags, here he is, the champ. Who'd have thought?
This was a big shot. He was one up when he got to four and had this situation where he played the opposite fairway to be able to attack this pin. Almost made an albatross. That was an eagle to go two up. Ishimi was fighting back with the putter, was trying to. He had these long putts, and he made some miraculous putts to keep this match going. Got it at this point to just two down at the turn. However, F Magnets really started to put things back on at the start of the back nine.
Yeah, and look at this, you know, like with races and athletics and any golf, you win by inches, by millimeters, and unfortunately when your putts do things like that, it's going to cost you.
That was an eagle hole out by
and when your putts do things like that, you're going to capitalize.
That was the second hole of the final after he lost the first hole. But then from then on, I mean, you look at, we were talking about the math of the front nine. Only two holes were halved. F Magnets would go on to win five of the next seven holes, I believe, to get to that four-up advantage through eight. Young 46 chipped away, but F-Max was able to put it together at the end. And Jules, he talked about it, really 14 through 18 at Oakmont. Those are holes you don't know, was kind of what he said. Because of the way those holes are constructed, there could be some eagles in there, depending on how the wind hits things. So he knew he had to take advantage of that early lead to put away Young 46.
Yeah, if you don't have to play 17 and 18 at Oakmont, great. Don't do it if you don't have to. And he didn't. I mean, enough said. He played so well and consistently.
Jules, when you look back at today, you know, we start the day, we don't know where things are going to go. Young 46 was the number one overall seed. What made it so a player like F Magnets, what makes it so that a player like F. Magnuson can show up on any given day and get things done as we look ahead to Pinehurst number two for our next match play event?
Well, like I said, I think he's in a really great place right now with his game. He's finally got a season championship title. I think that's really important. His performance on Oakmont recently. He's just got all parts of his game working, and he's got the experience and the composure to do that. So, yeah, we're going to be seeing a lot more of him and a lot more of Young 46 as well. Remember, they beat lots and lots of players in many rounds in order to get here to the final today. So it's not like they've played a couple of rounds. I mean, they've had to work really hard to get to this position. They are fantastic players. Well, all our semi-finalists were who played today. Well done to all of them for getting this far. But of course, the biggest congratulations goes to F Mags. So I think our next tournament, Jeff, which you're going to be hosting, right, is going to be on the 4th of November.
You can see it right there.
Sorry, I'm looking at the camera. Yes, if I'm looking at the screen, here it is. Exactly. We'll be playing at Pinehurst number two, which, of course, we were mentioning before. F-Mags looking like he's going to relish that opportunity to play there again.
Jules Brook doing the correct professional thing, looking into the camera as I'm looking here at the screen. But November 4th, that is the Match Play Challenge at Pinehurst number two. This has been the Match Play Challenge at Oakmont. Your champion, F Magnets, 3-2 in the final against Young 46. Jules, thanks for being with us today. I am Jeff Eisenband.
Thank you for having me.
Have a great Saturday. Enjoy the fall golf. Enjoy some of the Match Play events coming up, and we will see you in November.
Thank you.